Hi guys, this is Nivita. In this video, I'm going to tell you how to introduce a chapter for some students who are in your class. Okay, so I'm going to take coordinate geometry chapter. So first of all, when you enter the class, the students they used to do their work of the last class. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to grab the attention of the students. For that, as a maths teacher, you can do, you can ask them to tell the tables from 6th to 12th and all. Because the mind should be turned to you, right? Then only you can impart some of the education to them. So, for that, what is the main thing is you need to grab the attention. For that, you can ask them to tell the tables, you can ask the you can ask question like 6 8 sal, what is the answer of 6 8 sal, what is the answer of 8 9 sal. You can also ask like that. Okay, after that, if you feel everyone in the class is under your control or everyone is not distracting, okay, after that, what you can do is you can go into the topic. So the first thing you need to do is writing the subject as max in the board. Most of the B.Ed students are not doing this. Okay, so try to remember. First thing you need to do is you need to rub the board clean, clean the board, and you should write the subject as max. After that, I'm going to take coordinate geometry. Okay, but you don't say it directly like we are going to see the chapter coordinate geometry and all. You should not tell. Okay, so for that, what you can do is you can give some motivation, you can give some introduction about this chapter, and you need to get some answer from the students. Then only it is like a child-centered education. Okay, the introduction and all, it should not be like teacher-centered, it should be like child-centered. For that, what you can do is coordinate geometry, the main application of coordinate geometry is in Google Maps. Okay, so you can ask like, have you seen Google Maps, have you used Google Maps, how it locate the address correctly, and all you can ask. Okay, so after that, you can tell them that in Google Maps and all, we are using the max. Okay, first thing you can tell them like this. Second thing is geometry. You can ask them like, have you draw circle, square, rectangle, right? So by using scale, pencil, by using the measurements and all, they used to draw, right? So example, by using radius, they can draw a circle. By using the same side length, they can draw a square. By using a length and breadth, they can draw a rectangle, right? So geometry refers to drawing the shapes and all. Okay, so by this geometry, we are going to see another new chapter. You can introduce like this, because most of the students love to do the geometry in their previous classes. So you can tell them like it is just a continuation of geometry. Okay, then you can write the topic as coordinate geometry. You can ask question like, what is coordinate geometry? Do you have any idea of coordinate geometry? You can ask. After that, what you need to do is you need to explain the two words. Okay, coordinate geometry. So already we have explained about the what is geometry and all. We are going to explain about coordinate. Okay, so the I'm going to draw x-axis and y-axis. Okay, before that, you can tell them like, you are drawing a number line. Okay, this is 0, 1, 2, 3. This is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Have you seen this? You can ask them. After that, you can ask them to locate the number 2. Then they will be saying like 2. Okay, suppose if you ask them to locate 0, they will say 0 is here and all. Okay, so this is a single line with with the numbers 1 2 3 0 1 2 3 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3. The same thing we are going to put it here also. This is origin and here 1 2 3 4, here minus 1 minus 2 minus 3 minus 4. Okay, suppose if you are given numbers like 2, plot 2 means you can do. If they are asking for the number 0 means you can mark it like this. If they are asking for minus 2 means you can ask like this. Okay, suppose they are asking you to plot 2 comma 3. They are asking you to plot 2 comma 3, which is a pair, right? Pair means what? It has two numbers. So it has two numbers. This is known as ordered pairs. This is known as ordered pairs. So how we can plot this ordered pairs? So for this, you can mark this as x-axis and this is x-dash. This is y-axis and this is y-dash, right? After that, you can see like x refers to the positive numbers, x dash refers to the negative numbers, y refers to positive numbers. Y refers to positive numbers. Here y dash refers to negative numbers. Y dash refers to negative numbers. Okay, this is the basic of graph and all. You can also do like you can use the scale to put x and y axis and all. So you just draw the axis like this. These two lines, no, this is vertical line. Okay, after that you need to tell them like this is vertical line. Vertical line refers to x axis. Vertical line refers to x axis. And this is horizontal line. Horizontal line. And this horizontal line refers to y-axis. You can also tell them like funny, this is a sleeping position, right? This is a standing position. Sleeping refers to the vertical and standing refers to the horizontal. Okay. So, here the ordered pairs, no. Here the two refers to x coordinates and y refers to y coordinate. The second number refers to y coordinate. Okay, the first number refers to x coordinate and the second number refers to y coordinate. Then we are going to plot this ordered pairs in this graph. Okay, we are going to plot this ordered graph in this graph. This is 2 comma 3. First thing is x coordinate, right? So you need to search for 2 in this coordinate, in this axis. So here the number 2 is here. Okay, after that 3, you need to search 3 in y axis. So here there is minus 3, here there is 3, right? So you can mark this and you can draw extended line and you can draw an extended line. This point is marked as 2 comma 3. This point is marked as 2 comma 3. So you can give some more examples also. So, in coordinate geometry, we are going to study about the coordinates like x coordinate, y coordinate, which represents the ordered pairs. We are going to study about those coordinates only. And we are going to see how this coordinate geometry helps to do Google Maps and all. Helps in Google Maps and all. Here, we are going to mark the paths. Okay, here this point, okay, the intersection point refers to 0 comma 0, which can be said as origin, and this axis, right, it is termed as x. Here the another name for the x coordinate is abscissa and another name for y coordinate is ordinate. And the ordered path 0 comma 0 refers to origin. Okay, x coordinate, the another name for x coordinate is abscissa, another name for y coordinate is ordinate, and 0 comma 0 point refers to origin. So in this particular thing, we can even draw shapes like rectangle, square and all, right? These are all geometrical figures. So here in the corner and all, we will be having some points. For example, this point refers to minus 2 comma 2, and this point refers to minus 2 comma 3. This point refers to minus 4 comma 3. This point refers to minus 4 comma 2. Right. So by using coordinates, we are drawing some shapes. So that is why it is termed as coordinate geometry. Okay. Now we are going to see some of the applications of coordinate geometry in real life. We are using Google Maps from time to time. No. So their coordinate geometry is used. So I'm going to see show you one picture. You can see in Google Map, right, like this, right? So here all the places are marked with points. Okay, so after that, what they used to do is, in Google Maps and all, the distance between them, the time interval between them, everything it shows, right? Because using coordinate geometry, we can find the distance between the two points. Okay, after that, after some manipulation, you can find the reaching time and everything. So for the Google Maps and all, coordinate geometry is the main thing. Okay, after that, in Google Maps, then in physical maps also. In physical map means we are having some copy of the map. No, there also coordinate geometry is used by using some dots. Okay, they are joining the map. After that, large scale land project. Large scale land projects, which refers to in land projects and all, they used to mark everything as points, and they used to plan everything. Okay, after that, in naval engineers, in ship and all, they used to do some engineering works. So their coordinate geometry is used. So basically, coordinate geometry is the addition of algebra plus geometry. Algebra plus geometry. How it is known to be a combination of algebra and geometry means, in algebra, y is equal to 3x minus 1, and all we used to see those equations. So for that, we used to put one tabular column. Here it is x-axis and here it is y-axis, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Suppose if I substitute minus 1 here, 3 into minus 1, minus 1. Here it is minus 3, minus 1, which is equal to minus 4. And then 3 into 0, minus 1, it is minus 1. Then 3 into 1, minus 1 is 3, minus 1 is 2. Then 3 into 2, minus 1 is 3, 2 is 6, minus 1 is 5. Right, by using in algebra and all, we used to study those equations. So I am going to plot that. This is x-axis, this is x dash, this is y-axis, and this is y dash. For that, minus 1 comma minus 4, 0 comma 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. The first point is minus 1 comma minus 4, minus 1 comma minus 4. Second point is 0 comma minus 1, 0 comma minus 1, 1 comma 2, 2 comma 5. So here we are joining the line, right? So what we are using, we are drawing a straight line. We are drawing a straight line, which refers to geometry. And here we are having the equation, which is algebra. Then what I am getting? I am getting ordered pairs, right? Minus 1 comma minus 4, 0 comma minus 1, 1 comma 2, 2 comma 5. Those are all ordered pairs. So this refers to coordinate geometry. Right. So by using algebra and geometry, we are gaining coordinate geometry. So here you can find the points here, here, here. Okay, these are all the basic things you should learn in coordinate geometry. Here, this man name is René Descartes, who is a father of coordinate geometry. Okay, if you want to clearly explain the students what is coordinate system means, you can show this picture. Okay, suppose if you want to make sure there are so much of person here, you want to locate one particular person means, what you can do is by fixing this flag, no, by fixing this flag into origin, you can mark everything into points. Here you can see this is a flag, you can mark it as a coordinate system. After that, by plotting points and all, you can easily tell the location of some places or some man. You can easily tell them, right? That is what the coordinate geometry. The next most important thing is you should learn this first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. Okay, so like we have our house. In our house we will be having like a drawing room, veranda, kitchen. Likewise, in graph also there are some room like structure which is termed as first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. There is no important like it has to be do everyone is following in anti-clockwise direction only. Okay, so there is no particular reason for that. For the convention they are using it as like anti-clockwise. Okay, then in first quadrant everything is plus plus. Here this is also plus, this is also plus. In second quadrant always you should take x-axis first, so this is negative and this is positive, so minus comma plus. Here x-axis is also having minus symbol, y-axis is also having minus symbol, so minus comma minus. Here x-axis is having positive and y-axis is having negative, so plus minus. So these are the four quadrants. Hope you understood how Google Maps maps are all working using coordinate geometry. Okay.